अर्जुन टुडे जावा लैब और वेब लैब।
सर वेब
हाँ
वेब सर
वेब टुमारो जावा लैब। हाँ
यस सर
हेलो। Right. So tomorrow we'll try to do two programs. So all of you try to attend tomorrow without fail. So let us start the fourth unit today. So we have seen servlets. So servlet program separately, HTML code separately. We were giving the links between two to run the web programming web related programs. Using the browser, we have done it. Next, we have done Java Server Pages, JSP. So that one is nothing but directly one program only. Instead of servlets, two programs, here only one we have done it. And here also almost the same way. But compared to servlet, here bit easy. So next one is the beans. Beans, we have done it like AWT extension, we have told. And here is nothing but the simple way of drawing the graphs and drawing the images or displaying the images. For that purpose, we have used the Java beans. That is what we did it. Now we move to the fourth unit, that is called the JDBC connection. This is also most important for Java programs, how you will be giving the JDBC. So till now we have done only front-end programs and like directly we are executing and we are displaying here itself. Through keyword we are taking the input values and we are displaying that stuff. So now onwards. So given now, you try to use a BMSIT login area only.
Sir, today AJP lab, sir.
Okay, that's what, but last week, anyway, I'll come back. I'll ask him if he's taking okay, otherwise I'll take no problem. Okay.
Yes,
so last week sir took no.
Yeah, sir. So I told today is the
that's what correct. Even normally first we scheduled Wednesday AJP lab and Thursday that one. But I don't know without my knowledge he has taken last week. Let us see. If he takes okay, otherwise we will take. No problem. 1-5-10 minutes we'll adjust, no problem. I'll by that time I'll speak to him. If you get any information, let me know. Otherwise, we'll take no problem. I'll be taking, I don't have any problem. Only thing is, loudly I cannot talk, but slowly I'll talk and I'll manage the class, no problem. You can able to hear me, no? My voice is no problem, no?
Yes, sir, we can hear, no problem.
Okay, okay. Probably it may take one more week to come to the normal position. Okay, so now today's class onwards JDBC connections. Preliminary things we'll see it, then we'll move to the NetBeans. There we have to see how to connect the database connections. That's all. So database connections, one program if you know, based on that only we'll be doing. So I was telling the front end connections, front end programs we have did it, Java we have done, Ada we have did it, all these things through keyboard we have given the input values and we displayed there itself. Either input or output, we didn't store anywhere. That is what we did it. Now, JDBC connection is nothing but Java database connection. Here is nothing but why we are using is not the database connection is nothing but the informations will be stored somewhere. That is called the backend. Any database we can take, either Excel we can take, SQL we can take, MySQL we can take, any database, whatever it may be, no problems. And select commands we have to use it, And here we have to display using the front end. That is what we need to do it. That database connections, probably one day we have to listen carefully. That I will show you, probably another 2 days, probably next Monday I can show you. Basics are required now. Let us see what all the methods are available. What is that? How many methods are there? All these things we will learn it. Once we complete this, then we'll move to the practical problems. That means implementations of the practical, one or two examples we'll take and we'll implement that one. Once you know the database connections, then no problems. So here is the fourth module is nothing but annotations and JDBC. So here is nothing but, now we should have the idea, database connections is nothing but what? We have the front end and we have the back end. Back end, we are storing the informations, and using the front end, we'll through server, we'll move to the database, we'll extract the data. So the data rows and columns will be there. As you know, the data DBMS, you have done it already. DBMS, you have did it. So there you know how to create the tables, how to insert the values, all these things. Now here, either we inserting the values into the database, or retrieving the database, retrieving the data from the database, or modifying, deleting, whatever it may be, the operations we'll be doing through front end. That is what we'll be doing. So DBMS, what we did it there, you have created the table there itself, and you are trying to insert the values, and then you have retrieved the data, and you have displayed based on the queries. Based on the queries. So you may be having 2 to 3 databases. Maybe probably I want to take one database, one information, another database, one more information, one more data, maybe 2 to 3 data fields, whatever you want. So we can take it here, and so big data analytics, all these things, I don't know. So select commands. So what all the information is required. So best example, I can take, what is that now? Aadhaar cards informations. So how they're tracing out, making the injections, all those things based on the other numbers on how many people took, how many people still are pending, all these things. So all these things, we can solve the problems. Let us move to the what is there in that annotations and JDBC connections. The following topics will be discussed in this module. So these are all the topics will be discussed, built in annotations with an examples. This is what most important in this. Once you learn this, then we can move to the JDBC connections. So customs annotations. So now let us talking to the small introduction for the database. Immediate solutions. What you can show the solutions for the problems. That means we can take simple problems and we can show the solutions. Essential JDBC programs. So what is the need for the JDBC programs? Using the prepared statement of the objects. So we can using the prepared the statement of the objects. Next one is interactive SQL tool. SQL structured query languages, you know that what all the commands are available. All these things we can type it and we can execute the programs. Next is JDBCs in action. So what type of actions will be taken? That we'll be seeing. Results set. So which way you want to display the result sets in front end? So back end, you know, you did it already, database, DBMS laboratory programs, but using that we have to do it. So try to learn once again the commands, how to write the queries, batch updates, because inserting the values and all, we'll create the table there itself and we'll insert the values, no problem. And retrieving the data or updating the data or inserting the values, commands we should know, that I will tell you. Batch updates, so batch. So how to update that one. Mapping, how you will be mapping one database to another database. Like primary keys, secondary keys, all these things, how you will be doing, how you will be managing in that. Next is basic JDBC data types, what all the data types are available in that. Advanced JDBC data types, basics and advanced both data types we'll be learning here, and immediate solutions. So these are all the topics will be covered in JDBC connections. This is what the topics will be covered. At the end of the chapter, you will be learning all these things. Now let us see one by one. So annotations. So annotations is nothing but the either metadata or data of data. So normally when we are having small questions, 2 marks questions and all, they'll be asking this one only. So what is the annotations? So that is nothing but the either metadata or data of data. Data about the data. So metadata is nothing but the, so you know, the information that's all. So whatever you are storing the data, so that is called the data about the data. So that is what the annotations. So this is indicates that declared element should be processed some special way of special way by the compiler, development tools, deployment tool, or during the runtime. So during the runtime, these are all the things will be happening. So you have the data of data. So that is nothing but you have stored into the database. So this is the process. What process? When you are requesting something from the front end, your through server should go to the database, and whatever you have written the commands, based on that, taking the informations and coming out from that, and it will be displaying here. So how you have done the structure format for the displaying purpose. That is what the annotations. So annotations is nothing but the data of data. This is also process. So in that process, we'll be having the deployment tool and development tools. All these things will be should be working. Then only we can run the programs properly. That is what the annotations are, the metadata, or we can say data about the data. And annotations indicates that declare the element should be processed in some special way by the compiler. That is what the declare the element should be processed by some special way of the compilers. So you have the compiler when you are compiling the programs, all these things. So that will be processed, all these things, whether it is properly connected or not. So otherwise it will show the errors. Once I write the commands, giving the link between that one, whenever you are compiling, there is no error. Then we can retrieve the data or insert the data or modify the data, whatever it may be. So that one is nothing but compiler will be taking. So you should have the development tools, deployment tools, and during the runtime programs. That is what the annotations. So annotations is based on development, is certainly one of the largest Java development trends. So these are also one of the maximum, because data about the data or metadata, whatever it may be. So this is also one of the key role in database. Annotations is nothing but the, we cannot forget that. So this is what the most important. That is what the annotations based on the development is certainly one of the largest Java development trends. So this is also one is the key factor in the development role. Annotations can be applied to several Java elements. So this also can be used, can be developed. So some of the elements like packages and declarations. So we can use packages and declarations also in this case. We can use classes. We have learned the classes and constructors. We have learned methods. We have learned fields, variables, and etc. That means what? Whatever you have learned the core Java, all these things also are applicable in this case. All these things, whatever you have learned there, everything is applicable. Instead of taking the through keyboard, we'll be taking through database. We are doing the operations. That's all. So this is what the will be happening in this. So whatever we have learned in Java programming or core Java, so packages, declarations, we know how to do it. Here also it will be working. Classes also, you know how to declare, how to use the Java programming. These also possible. Constructors also, we learned, that is also possible. Methods or functions, we know how to declare, how to do it. And what are the fields? Fields is nothing but the database informations. So next is called the fields. Another one is called the variables and etc. So these were the supporting annotations also in Java, the following things. So packages, declarations, classes, constructors, methods, fields, variables, and etc. So now build in annotations with an examples. So let us see some of the with small examples what we can do in this case. So the goal is nothing but for the annotations. So we have to allow the programmers to provide the additional informations about the programs. So that is additional informations about the programs is nothing but what? So how to give the connection, JDBC connections, what are the settings to be done? All these things is a responsible for the programmer. That is what they allow the programmer to provide the additional informations about the program. This informations can be used by software engineering tools. So this is already tools are available. Only thing is we should know how to utilize the write the program using the JDBC connections. So that means what are all the connections, how to give the connections, how to make, what are the changes to be done, all these things you should know. That is what the goal, allow the programmer to provide additional informations about the program. This information can be used with the software engineering tools. So software, this informations you are giving the additional informations about the programs for the programmer. So this information can be used with the software engineering tools. So the second one, an annotation is a type defined using the interfaces like the syntaxes. So we can write the interfaces like syntaxes, whatever you are writing the interface. For example, if you take the similar way here also syntaxes are available. So based on the syntaxes, you need to write the code. That's what we'll be learning in this. The next one is called the, so an annotation can be specified whenever a modifier is allowed. So modifier is allowed. So that means what, once we do it, modifications is allowed. So convention before the public or static modifiers. So this is left to the programmers in the annotations. So which way you want to modify or you want to change, whatever you want to make it, either private or public or static, whatever it may be, you have the options to write the code by your own. So which way you want to do it. So the security conditions, all these things related to the programmer only. So programmer can write all the rules, regulations, conditions, all these things in the data database. That is also one point in annotations. So the next one is annotations do not affect the semantics of the class. So annotations do not affect the semantic of the classes. So whatever you are writing the programs, semantic rules, your system software, you have done this semantics, all these things when the process or compiler will be doing. So changes, what will be happening, all these things, that is nowhere related here. So whatever the errors are available, that it will be displayed. So that's all. Remaining will not be affected, reflected. So that is what this one. Annotations do not affect the semantics of the class, but may affect the semantics of the things using the class, like tools, code generation, runtime options, etc. So it affects the semantics of the things using the classes. So what are all the tools you are using, code generations, runtime options, all these things will be affected. That means what are all the tools you are using, that should be affected. And code generation, so whatever you are writing, which tools you are using, when you are compiling that, when it is converting to the class files, all these things will be, reflections will be happening using the semantics. So that is what the runtime options. So either runtime options, you know that either you have the public or static, what, which way you want. So that is what the etc. Next is examples, definitions of annotations. This is what you can practice if you have pen book. So public at interface, my annotations, open bracket, and here the closing. So you have string to do something options. That means that is nothing but the, you have the methods to write to perform the particular task. So that is what the, so here is what public at interface name, interface name, open bracket, to do something, you have to write the methods. So to do string, to do something, there is called one method, that's all. So now examples to write, annotate your code annotations. So see here, I have written just my annotations, this one, and do something. Do something is nothing but what to do. Just that is called string, you are passing what to do. So here is public void, my method, open bracket, close bracket, you can perform the task. So these were the examples for the annotations, public at interface, interface name, open bracket, and you write the methods to perform the task. There is one. Otherwise, you can write the my annotations, the other way, examples also you can write it. My annotations to do something, that is nothing but what you have to do it. So what you want to perform that one, you can write it there and write the methods. So public void my method and write the code what you want to perform that one. So these were the syntaxes. You have to practice once the syntaxes, all these things. Then only we can be able to implement the code. So here is the structure of the Java 5 compilers. So how it will be there, how to convert it the class files. So you have the code, either basic core programming or advanced, whatever it may be, the Java files. So you have the source code. So whatever you are writing the file name, that is called the source file. So parser will be there. So parser, you are doing the processing for the compilation, that one. Program with the annotations. So take the checkers. So if you have the any errors, that means whenever you are compiling, if you have any errors, and again you have to rectify it. So if there is no errors, so go back to that one. Next is annotation checkers. So here is annotation checker plugins. So here you have the Java, many plugins are there. It will be checking all these things, everything, whether it is working or not. So normal code will be working here. And if you have any additional plugins in this, this annotations will be checking. So if you have any errors, you check it out. Otherwise, what will happen? It will create the file, class file. So that is what, using the class file writer, using the class file writer will be created the class file. So this is what the process in Java 5 compiler. That means what? Whatever we are writing the program, we are converting, we are compiling the program, that is nothing but the high level language to machine level language, because machine will understand only the machine level language. So in that process, after compilation, it will be created the class. Once create the class file, so then only we can be able to run the programs if there is no errors. So here source file to class file, when it is creating Java structure of the Java 5, so you have the parser will be there, track checkers will be there, annotations checkers will be there, then it will be created the, if everything goes fine, if there is no errors, it will be created the class file for the without errors. This is what the structure of the Java compiler. Structure of the Java compiler. So next is predefined annotations. Now we'll see one by one what it will be there, how it will be working. So predefined annotations is nothing but at overwrite. So you have the overwrite, depreciated, and suppress warning. So these are all the, how it will be working, we have to see one by one. So overwrite methods, already you have done it. So it will be created the, your NetBeans, Java NetBeans, it will be created the structure of the programming. So sometimes if you are adding any methods, new methods extra, there will be writing overwritten, overwrite. So same thing here also. Aside the intention to override a method in superclass, compiler fails if not actually overwriting. So if you are not writing this one will be get confusion, how to do, what to do, all these things. So that is the reason when you are changing any code for the particular methods, you will write the overwritten. that is called the here override here also. So assert intention to override a method in a superclass, that is nothing but the compiler fails if not actually overwriting. Like check spelling, override versus override. Next is depreciated. So depreciated is nothing but, so indicates that an element should not be used. So that element should not be used, it will indicate that. That is what the depreciated. Next is suppress warnings. So warning is nothing but compiler will giving the warnings when you are using this. So what type of warnings we'll be seeing in the programming. Tell the compiler to suppress the specific warnings. Suppress the specific warnings will be given. So this is nothing but the specific warnings will be given for the users. So next is, what all the types are available is nothing but, you have the three types. One is called the
marker.
Second one is called the single element. Third one is called the full value or multi values. Marker, single element, full value or multi values. So these three are annotations types. Marker, single element, full value or multi values. These three. Next, we'll see one by one what is the structures, how it will be working. The first one is called the marker. So marker is a annotations take no parameters. So without parameters, marker will be working. This, they are used to mark a Java element to be processed in a particular way. So marker is nothing but what? Without parameters, we'll be using the markers, and these are used to mark the Java elements to be processed when you are processing in the particular way. So let us see the examples here. Public, you have the interface, interface name, so my annotations, and this one. Next is the usage is nothing but at my annotations, public void my method, so method name, and there is no parameters in this case marker. So open bracket, close brackets, and close this one. Next is single element. So single element is nothing but, you know, name itself is saying one values will be passing. So single element or single value type. Single element or single value types also. Either strings or single elements also into the based on the data types. So string also one basic data type. One data type, that is the reason here they pass the one string. So now let us see how it will work in this. Single element or single value type annotations provide a single piece of data only. So it will be, condition is nothing but what? It will be passing only one. That is what the piece of data only. This can be represented with a data is equal to value pair or simply with the values. A shortcut syntax is nothing but only within the parameters. So now let us see the examples here. Public at interface, my annotations. So you have to write the methods. So the examples is nothing but at my annotations and single in syntax. That is called the what to do. So that is called one type of the string, that's all. And public void my method. So methods you can write it. And my annotations, whenever you are writing, pass the single element. So that is what the here. So previously we have seen marker. This is what the single element. Marker and single element. Next is called the full value or multi values. Full value or multi values. So full or multi. So that is nothing but what? Multi is nothing but what? More than one elements. So more than one elements, how to do it? So let us see the more than one value, how to write it. So full value type annotations have multiple data members. So exams also same thing, you have to write one example, one usage. One example, one usage. Finally, we have to write one program. Now, public at interface, my annotations, string to do something. So do something, int count, so string data. So more than one functions, more than one methods and variables also declared in this case. That is what the full value or multi values. So here full value I'm passing. That is called the int count. Multi values is nothing but multiple functions also you can utilize in this, or passing the parameters also. So full value or multi values, passing the parameters in your methods. So now you says at my annotations to do something, that is nothing but one string, you need to pass it. Here what to do you are passing. Count is equal to 1, date is equal to 9/9/2005. So this is what more than one values or multi values, whatever you call it. So here is integers, that is the reason count is equal to 1. Date you are passing because like string format you are passing, that is what the within the quotations we are entering in this. And one more methods, you have the public void my method. So under that you can write some code what you want to do. So our intention is nothing but the how to pass the multiple to do something. To do something, for that one value count is equal to 1 and date is equal to one more string. So integer you are passing, string also you are passing. First one and third one is called the string and second one is called the integer values. So integer means not required to put it into the single quotes. Wherever you have the single quotes, that is called the characters. Without quotations, that is called the integers. With double quotes is nothing but the strings, that already you know that. So C++ whenever we are learning, so teacher used to say that whenever you are using the string double quotes, whenever you are using the single characters it should be single quotes. So that one we learned it in C++ itself. So now Java also same thing. So when you have the more than one values. So we have seen first one is called the single value marker, single, and third one is called the full value or multi values. Marker, single value, full value or multi values. These are the three types of the annotations. So now these were the way of utilizations. So write my annotations and pass the more than one data types and one more methods is left to you. Next is the build and annotations. You have the Java defined several built-in annotations. So four are imported from java.language.annotations. So directly we can download from the java.language.annotations. At retention, documented, target, and inherited. These are all the 4 points. One is called the retention, documented, target, and inherited. These are all the four. Retention, documented, target, and inherited. So now three are the included in the Java language. So java.languages, three are there. One is called the overridden, overwrite. Second one is called the depreciated. And third one is called the suppress warnings. So you have the java.language.annotations. In that you have the retention, documented, target, and inherited. And another one is called the java.onlylanguage. In this you have three, overwritten, depreciated, and third one is called the suppress warnings. So now let us see simple annotations are the standard annotations. So what is that called? This one overwritten, depreciated, and this one. So there are the three types of the simple annotations provided by JDK 5. So we are using the JDK 5 textbook using JDK 5. So they are the first one is called the override, depreciated, and surplus warnings. So this is the three are there. Now let us see what is override, what is depreciated, and what is the surplus warning. So already you know that overwritten. So wherever you are using the overwritten's, whenever you are writing the new methods, and so some of the cases, new methods, whenever you are writing, it will show the error. It we have to write the overwritten. So here also the same thing, that is called the overwrite. That is, you know that this one normally we have done it when we done it the servlets or JSP programs. So overwrite is a marker annotations type that can be applied to your methods to indicate to the compiler. So what is that? What it will be there? Overwritten is nothing but what? So you are applying to do the methods to indicate that the compiler that methods overreads the method in a superclass. So in a superclass, that method should be overwritten. You are telling the compiler to do the override this particular methods in a superclass. So this annotations type guards the programmer against making the mistakes when overwriting the methods. For example, syntax is nothing but at override. So this, I hope everybody knows the override. So no need to learn once again here. So you know how to write it. So here is just examples. We have written class parent, public float values calculated, and we have taken float A, float B, written A comma B. So parent. Now, wow, you are extending one more class in this case. Whenever you want to override the methods, declare the override annotations type before the methods. So here is, you have the, this is called the parent class multiplied with the A and B. So inheritance, you can say public class. So child you have taken, extends the parents. So last year when we learned the basic Java programming, there we have learned this one. How to calculate the third unit, third chapter, inheritance. Third or fourth, I hope. Third only. So inheritance, we have learned it that in third chapter. So we know how to write the inheritance. So you have the parents, you have the childs. So best example also, we have seen the properties of the grandfather, father, grandchildren, how they inherited the properties. Or you have done UCPC classes and some of the common fields and some of the different fields, how it will be working. So we have seen. So similarly here also to write the methods here. So public class child extends the parents. You know how to write the this one also. So this is nothing but the class, public class name extends which one, this one. So this properties you have inherited here. Public calculate int A comma int B. So whatever you are written the A values and B values, enter A comma B. So written A plus 1 into B. So whatever you have written the A values plus 1 into B. Suppose if you are passing 5 and 6, 5 plus 1, 6, 6 into 6, 36. So that is what the way of writing the overwritten's. So overwritten is simple. So this programs we can write it easily. So take one base class, one derived class, and some calculations we can do it, whether multiplication or division or adding or subtracting, whatever it may be. Some of the operations you are supposed to do it. Next is the second one. So this one is nothing but the second one is called the depreciated. So depreciated is nothing but what? Showing the warnings. So some of the cases it will show the warnings. So this is what we can use the depreciated annotations. So this is, you have to remember, overwritten is nothing but what you're telling the compiler to do the superclass, what changes you made it, what methods you have written it. But now depreciated annotations is nothing but what you are telling, system will be giving the warnings. So this is what some of the warnings, any something goes wrong, warnings we can display. So let us see this one. This annotation indicates that when a depreciated the program element is used, the compiler should warn you about examples too. Shows you to the depreciated annotations. Now let us see here the examples how it will be working. So just depreciated is nothing but what? Showing the warnings. That's what you remember it. So showing the some of the warnings. Compiler will show the warnings. That's all. So syntax is at depreciated. So example, public class depreciated test at depreciated. At depreciated. So previously is nothing but the what? Overwritten, overwritten. So here is, so normally here, before methods we used to write it in the servlet. Here we have to write the after this, that's all the differences. And depreciated and do the do some particular class. Now, if you use or overwrite the depreciated methods, you will get warning at compile time. So if you use the override depreciated, you will get the warnings. It will show the warnings for this, which function is working or something else, some of the errors or whatever it may be. It will show the errors. It will give the warnings for the particular programs. So you'll get warnings at the compile time. So now, how to write it in the public class, depreciated test 2. This is nothing but the depreciated test. This is nothing but the depreciated test 2. So public static void main string arguments. Depreciated test, create the object and new depreciated test. Now test is the object, test.service. So test.service, this method you are calling in this. So this method will be working. Whatever you have written to perform particular task, that it will be executed. This is what the depreciated annotations. So first one is called the overwritten. Second one is called the depreciated annotations. Right. So next one is called the last one, surplus warning annotations. So this is nothing but the so here is warnings will be given specific to the types, constructors, methods, fields, parameters, and local variables. So suppose if you mention this one there, when you are running for the particular method, programs warnings, but here is, it will go in deep, warnings at one. So suppress warning is used to suppress the compiler warnings. You can apply at suppress warnings to types, constructors, methods, fields, parameters, and local variables. For all these things, you can whenever you want to display the warnings, you can use it the at suppress warnings. Next, the syntax is at surplus warnings. Examples, we have to do it the import java.utility-date if you take public class main at surplus warnings value is equal to depreciation. So this depreciation for every methods it will be displaying the warnings. So public static void main string arguments, you know how to write it. Date is equal to the object name is called date, new date of 2009 9:30, there we have given it, and system.out.println date. So this object, so this it will be displayed here. So that is called the plus date. So these are all the three methods. One is called the overwritten. What are the methods? Another one is called the second one is called the depreciated, and third one is called the surplus warning annotations. So this is what the today's class, and next class we'll see documentations, how to write the simple programs. We'll see the next class. Okay, right. So now normally we have to do the quiz, all those things. Because of my health issues, I couldn't able to do it. Now, orally, I'll ask you some of the questions. Just tell it, that is the most sufficient. So now, we have learned the JDBC basic things. And the first one we have learned today, so we have discussed about the annotations only. What is annotation? Anybody can say what is the definitions for the annotations? Bhavisha?
So metadata or data about data.
Data of data, very good. Data of data or metadata, right. So that is what the annotations. And next one is called the what we learned. So what is the annotations type we learned, Vishal? Annotations type?
Sir?
Yeah. What are the annotations type? Three types I told. What are all the three? Shruti? Three annotations I told. Yeah. What are all that?
Sir?
Annotations type I told three. What are all that?
Annotations.
Can you tell me annotations types?
Sir, documented.
That is not annotations types. Anybody else? Arjun?
Sir, marker, single value, multi value.
Yes. Marker, single element, full value or multi values. Right. So depreciated, what is depreciated? How to use it? Can you tell me? Anybody? Ashok? Lakshmi, what is overridden?
So many forms, the same, one form, many functions. So.
One form, many functions. Okay. What is depreciated? Vishal? Vinny? What is depreciated? Showing the warnings, that's all. I don't know why you people are struggling to say that. So you have to listen, then only you can be able to say that. Easy Java, advanced Java. Only thing is you have to practice, that's all. Right, now I'll take the attendance. Is it clear today's class? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Right, now I'll take the attendance. So, Bhushan sir messaged me. I hope you will be taking the lab today. Tomorrow, I'll be taking. Okay,
okay, sir.
Today, 12/05/21. AJP. 1150 plus. Answer your attendance. 1.
Present, sir.
2. 2. 3.
Present, sir.
4.
Yes, sir.
5.
Present, sir.
6. 7.
Present, sir.
8. 9. 10.
Present, sir.
11.
Present, sir.
12.
Present, sir.
13. 13. 14.
14. Present, sir.
16.
Present, sir.
17.
Present, sir.
18.
Present, sir.
18.
Sir, present, sir.
19.
Present, sir.
20.
Present, sir.
21.
Present, sir.
22.
Present, sir.
23.
Present, sir.
24
present sir
25
yes sir
26
present sir
27
yes sir
28 29
yes, sir.
29 30
present sir
3D series 2
present sir
3
present sir
4
present sir
5
present sir
6 7
present sir
8
present sir
9
present sir
10
present sir
11 11 12
present sir
13
present sir
14
yes sir
15 16
present sir
17
yes sir
18
present sir
19 20
present sir
21
present sir
22
present sir
23
present sir
right okay so sir will be taking afternoon sir, lab or I will be taking yeah
sir by2 present sir
huh
by2 present sir
by2
yes, sir. Right sir internet lost
okay
sir by18 present sir
done shall I stop